Good morning, students. Today I'll discuss few questions based on general concept of reflection of light, and I'll tell you what is the shortcut method to solve and verify the answers. So let's start. See here the question. The real image, be careful, the real image formed by concave mirror is larger than the object when the object is. So first you think about questions. What is given? Concave mirror. So concave mirror is given. Which type of image is formed? Real image. Real image. Now this image is larger than the object. See here, one thing students you remember, focus, center of curvature. When object will be at infinity or beyond C, image is always smaller, that is diminished. We have to get image that is larger than object. Now I think you are remembering, whenever the object is coming nearer to the mirror, image is going far from the mirror. But there is one place where same size of image we will get, that is at C. So C, similar size image we will get. Now when image will proceed beyond C, it will be larger in size. So object will proceed between C and F. So object will proceed between C and F, image will go beyond C. Then only we will get larger image. Let's see the options. At a distance equal to radius of curvature. Equals to radius of curvature means it is at C. So at C we are getting same size image, which is not satisfied in question. Again, second one, at a distance less than focal length. Less than focal length means between P and F. Again, it is not satisfying. See, you will see, between focus and center of curvature, between when you will keep the object, that is image will be between C and F, then what? We will get the small real image formed concave mirror larger. We have to get the larger than object when the object is. We have to keep the object. Where we have to keep the object? Between C and F. And let's see the last one. At a distance greater than radius of curvature means beyond C. Beyond C, smaller image not possible. So what should be the answer? Answer will be C. Option C is correct. If you keep the object between C and F, we will get the larger image. Next, again, the real image formed by a concave mirror is smaller than the object. Means image is smaller than the object. So let's see the condition. If the object is, where we will keep the object so that image we will get smaller and real. Just now I have discussed in first questions that if the object will be at infinity or beyond C, the image will be smaller and or diminished. So let us see for this case. First case, between center of curvature and focus. If we are keeping the object between center of curvature and focus, center of curvature, if object is in between this, that means image will be bigger. So for first case, we will get larger image, A option. For it is not satisfied because we have to go get smaller image. For B, let us see what is happening. At a distance greater than radius of curvature. So greater than radius of curvature means object is beyond C. If object is beyond C, naturally the image will be between C and F and it is smaller real. Maybe B satisfied. First, then again check for C and D. At a distance equal to radius of curvature, at equal you are understanding it is same size image at C, and last at a distance equal to focal length. If we are keeping at a focus, then the object will be very, image will be very large. So option will be B, the real image is smaller when we are keeping the object at a distance greater than radius of curvature, means beyond C. So answer will be number B, satisfied. Again you come for C. The image formed by concave mirror is virtual, erect and magnified. I think students you are remembering, whenever the image is forming virtual and erect and magnified, when we are keeping the object within focal length, that means between P and F, object is between P and F, then image we will get virtual, erect and magnified. Remember the ray diagram. So let us see the position of object, which one is satisfied. At focus, no. When we keep the object at focus, the image will form at infinity. At focus, number A, image will form at infinity and it is highly magnified. Highly magnified, which is not satisfied for this question. Let us see B, between focus and center of curvature. Between focus and center of curvature, for B option, if we are keeping, then image will be beyond C. For B, image will be real and it should be beyond C. That is also not satisfied because we have to get what? Virtual and erect image. At pole, which is not possible. If you keep the object at pole, it is not, any image will not form. Between pole and focus. So between pole and focus, if we are keeping the object, we will get the virtual, erect and virtual, erect and magnified image. So option will be D. So D is satisfied. So again you see here, the image formed by concave mirror is real, inverted and same size. It's very easy as the object. The position of object will be, always remember, when it will be same size, that is position where we will keep the object, PF C. Always you remember, when we will keep the object at C, the image will be of same size. You draw the ray diagram and check it. So here let us start. At the focus, no. If we keep the object at focus, the image will form at infinity. Number B, between the center of curvature and focus, if we keep the object between F and C, the image will form beyond C, which is also not possible. At the center of curvature, yeah, this will satisfy, because at the center of curvature we get real, inverted and same size image. So answer will be C. Next you come, the angle of incidence for a ray of light passing through the center of curvature of a concave mirror is. So let us see, concave mirror, first we draw it, concave mirror, then we see focus, center of curvature. Any ray passing through center of curvature after reflection it retraces back in its own path. That means angle I is equal to angle R. This is the normal line, so light does not reflect. So let us see the answer. Answer will be, let us check it, 45 degree. No, it is not possible 45 degree. Second answer, 90 degree. It is also not possible because we have to get angle I is equal to angle R. So angle I should be 0 degree. So angle R also should be 0 degree, because you know that whenever a ray of light passing through normally, angle I is 0 as well as angle R is 0. Answer should be C. Next you come and last check it, 180 degree. So it will lies on the principal axis. That is also not possible. So here you see question number 6. In a concave reflector of torch, the bulb is placed. Now torch we are using just this shape, mouth of the torch. The bulb is placed. Where we will place the bulb? Between P and F. Between, if you place a bulb between P and F, then we will get a magnified image. That is not possible. At F, again at F, that is also not possible because image is formed, means light will go anywhere. It will not show whole of the field where we want to see. Between F and C, just see, between F and C, so F and C, it is also not possible. At C, it is. Which one is possible? At F. How and why I am showing you. If we keep the object at F, then what happens? Remember the rule for concave mirror. Ray of light passing through F, after reflection, it is parallel to the principal axis. Ray of light passing through F, after reflection, it is parallel to the principal axis. So if we are keeping a concave mirror at this side, so what we will find? It will just go out of the torch and we will able to see whole of the field. So answer will be at F. Next you come, the focal length of a small concave mirror is 2.5 centimeter. So what is given? Concave mirror means F is equal to minus 2.5 centimeter. In order to use this concave mirror as a dentist mirror, remember dentist used to see our tooth from concave mirror. So what type of image we will get? Image we will get, it should be virtual, it should be erect and magnified. Magnified. Now if we have to get virtual, erect and magnified image in concave mirror, where the object should be placed? It is at F, at C. Object should be placed between P and F. Object should be between P and F. So let us see answer. Focal length is minus 2.5 centimeter. So up to here it is minus 2.5 centimeter. So naturally object should be less than 2.5 centimeter. So let us see, 2.5 centimeter, it is not the correct option. B, 1.5 centimeter, so it is less than 2.5 centimeter. 4.5 centimeter, which is also greater than 2.5 centimeter. 3.5 centimeter, it is also greater than 2.5 centimeter. So what will be correct answer? Correct answer will be B. Next, an object is placed at a following distances from a concave mirror. Again, mirror is concave. We will notice it. Of focal length F is given, that is minus 15 centimeter. Turn by turn. Now, first of all, 35 centimeter, 30 centimeter, 20 centimeter and 10 centimeter. Which position of the object will produce? So, this is the position of object will produce. Let us see which one satisfied which one. Number 4, I am discussing number 1. Number 1, A magnified real image. So, I am discussing first this one. Let's start from 35 centimeter. So, it's 35. We have minus 35 centimeter. Now, I am showing you one shortcut method. See here. Mirror. Principal axis. Focus. Center of curvature. Focus is, focal length is 15 centimeter. So, distance from this pole and focus is 15 centimeter. Naturally, then center of curvature and pole to center of curvature will be double, that is 30 centimeter, and it will be minus 30 centimeter. F is minus 15 centimeter. See here, object is kept at minus 35 centimeter, means object is kept anywhere beyond C. If object is beyond C, naturally image will form between anywhere between C and F. So, your answer will be position of image will come between minus 15 centimeter to minus 30 centimeter. So, you will get this one. Now, let me solve and show you. Are we getting this one? So, we know mirror formula 1 by F is equal to 1 by V plus 1 by U. F is 1 by minus 30 centimeter is equal to 1 by V plus 1 by minus 35. Sorry, this one F is 15, 35. Whatever we have to calculate, we bring it that variable to left hand side. So, 1 by V minus 1 by V is equal to, this will go right hand side, 1 by 15 centimeter as side changes, sign changes, plus minus minus 1 by 35 centimeter. So, we get here minus 1 by V is equal to, take out LCM for 35 and 15, we will get it 35, 15, so 5, 7, 3, so we will get it 7, 3 is a 21, 5, that is 1, 0, 5, and this 1, 0, 5, 15, 7 times 7 minus 3, so we get here, that is 4 by 1, 0, 5, minus 1 by V, so we just opposite minus V is equal to 105 by 4. We get here 26.25 centimeter. V is minus, therefore V is equal to minus 26.25 centimeter. See here, minus real and inverted. And 26.25 centimeter lies between 15 to 30 centimeter. See, one general concept, we have got the correct answer. So, object will be where the image will be minus 15 to 30 centimeter in between. So, option, check it. For first case, 35 centimeter, which one is satisfied? Magnified real image. No, it is not satisfied because we are not getting magnified. Number 2, magnified virtual. No, we are getting real image. Number 3, a diminished real image. Yes, we are getting diminished, smaller in size, real image. So, for A option, number 3 will satisfy. Just see. So, like this, you can find out the answer by numerically also. After doing the numerical, check it by general concept we have got the correct answer or not. Second one come. Now general concept I am giving you 30 centimeter for second case. Number 2, F is minus 15 centimeter and U is minus 30 centimeter. So again, once you will calculate the numerical, check it and then say to me, send me answer. So F, C. U is 30 centimeter. Naturally, if F is minus 15 centimeter, C will be minus 30 centimeter. So where we will keep the object? So that is object is minus 30 centimeter. If object is at C, image will be what we are getting, that is same size, real and inverted. So let us check the answer. First, magnified, no, it is not. Magnified virtual, no. Diminished we have got for one, and fourth one, that is for B, an image same size. So for this case, answer will be B. Use homework, you do see numerically and then send me the answer. Third one, C, 20 centimeter. So third case, what we are getting, F is minus 15 centimeter, C is U is minus 20 centimeter. Now you will see here C is minus 30 centimeter means object is between C and F, between minus 15 to 30. 20 lies between minus 15 to minus 30 centimeter. So where will be the image? Now you have understood, if object is between C and F, image will beyond C. So let us check it, what will happen, and it image will be magnified. A magnified real image, these two we have got. So for first case, it will be C, answer will be C. And last one, D, that means focal length minus 15 centimeters, it is less than focal length, object lies between P and F. So image will be naturally virtual. So for 2, answer will be D. For 1, I have calculated. For 2nd, 3rd and 4th, you check it numerically. Are we getting the answer? And after checking, you take the general concept, verify your answer. Next. Linear magnification produced by rear view mirror. First of all, rear view mirror means convex mirror. Convex mirror fitted in vehicles. What will be the linear magnification? Magnification we know H dash by H. Let us check it one by one. Options. First one is equal to 1. When we get A, for A I am checking, is equal to 1. So naturally numerator is equal to denominator, then only we will get 1. Is it possible in convex mirror? No. So this will not satisfy. Come for B. Is less than 1. Less than 1 means we are getting H dash by H. This is denominator. If denominator will be less, then only we will get less than 1. So here it will show H, denominator will be greater, sorry. So H will be greater than H dash. Denominator will be greater, then only we will get the answer less than 1. So here what we are getting, M is less than 1. Maybe B1 correct answer, but check it C and D. Is more than 1. More than 1 means for C, numerator is greater than denominator, which is not possible. In convex mirror, image is always smaller. And D, depending on the position, it is also not possible, because it is possible in concave mirror. Whatever position you keep the object in, convex mirror, image you will get Same. So answer will be B. And the last question you come, in order to obtain a magnification of minus 0.6 of concave mirror, we know the magnification. Answer, magnification is minus V by U, that is equal to H dash by H. I think you know what is V, U, H dash and H. H dash size of image, H size of object. The object must be placed. Now where we will keep the object to get the linear magnification? This one. So let us see what we are getting. Minus real and inverted. It's okay. Now here 0.6 is less than 1, means denominator is greater. So we can write H is greater than H dash, or U is greater than V. U is greater than V. So let us find out where we will keep the object to get this. At focus. When we are keeping the object at focus, naturally we are getting H dash larger, image larger. This is not possible because we have to get less than 1. Between pole and focus. Between pole and focus, we will get virtual image. So this is also not possible. Between C and F. If you keep the object between C and F, image will be greater. And last is beyond center of curvature. If you keep the object beyond center of curvature, then just see, we are getting H dash, we will get smaller beyond center of curvature, and yours V will be less. We have to get less V. So answer will be D is satisfying. So what conclusion you have got? Whenever the object is coming closer to the mirror, image is going far from the mirror, there is one place at C where we will get same size image. And as object is going beyond C to F, that means image is passing just beyond C and it will be larger in size. So go through it and revise it. Okay.